Dear future viewer, the year 2020 sucked. But I'm assuming you already knew that.
People don't really understand it until you actually see it coming at you in a wall of flame.
At this hour, it appears no U.S. or foreign troops were killed or injured in this attack. This comes in response to a U.S. drone strike that killed Iran's top general.
However folks may feel about impeachment, the gravity of this moment is undeniable.
We just saw what is a very bitterly divided America on display. Virtually every Democrat voting for impeachment, every Republican voting against it.
The LA Times is reporting that retired Los Angeles Lakers basketball star Kobe Bryant has been killed in a helicopter crash.
When Kobe Bryant died, a piece of me died.
Here because President Trump is about to speak on the coronavirus outbreak. The White House calling the news conference as health officials in Washington State confirm a patient has died from the infection. State health officials say this is in the Seattle area, the first coronavirus death reported so far in the U.S.
I think we do need to understand that now is not the time for panic, that this is the time for preparedness.
The CDC says a man in his 50s with underlying health conditions has died and he had no known travel to China.
Ultimately, the goal is to ease the guidelines and open things up as we near the end of our historic battle with the invisible enemy. I said earlier today that I hope we can do this by Easter. I'm also hopeful to have Americans working again by that Easter, that beautiful Easter day.
I see your hands.
I'm sorry. More than 2 months after the death of George Floyd, tonight the clearest picture yet of what led up to the deadly confrontation.
Protests in hundreds of cities across all 50 states. More than 17,000 National Guard troops deployed. Over 9,000 civilians arrested. A national reckoning that has brought both chaos and change.
Prosecutors have charged the officer who then knelt on Floyd's neck with second-degree murder and manslaughter. The three other officers are accused of aiding and abetting him.
All four officers now charged in George Floyd's death. In Atlanta, one officer fired and two facing charges after the shooting death of Rashard Brooks. And after months of protests in Louisville, one of the three police officers involved in the killing of Breonna Taylor now fired.
I want to make sure.
You graduated last in your class, not first in your class.
I want to make
Mr.
sure.
Mr. President, can you let him finish, sir?
You folks at home, how many of you got up this morning and had an empty chair at the kitchen table because someone died of COVID?
You would have lost far
how
more
many
people.
People.
In the middle of a pandemic, almost 150 million Americans voted. And Joe Biden and Kamala Harris will receive the most votes of any presidential ticket ever.
Whether he chooses to concede is yet to be seen.
Ready to go?
Honey?
Yes?
You're asking me again, and I'm like, the dishes still aren't done. The trash is in all the place. It's gonna have bugs when we get back if we don't clean up.
Lindsay's opening her Christmas card from her parents.
Thanks, Mom and Dad.
All right, so we're about to pull out. There's Winnie. Say hi.
You ready? We're going far away. You've never been this far away. It's for Winnie's 21st birthday.
Yep.
And Christmas.
So, as you would expect, our 2020 ended in a way we didn't expect.
Long story short, we found ourselves with a fully loaded vehicle, but nowhere to go for Christmas.
So we packed up Winnie and hit the road. No real agenda, no real timetable, and no expectations whatsoever.
The closest thing we had to an agenda was the Grand Canyon and eventually.
Do not go any further.
Stop! Oh my God!
Making it home in one piece was optional. We did have a few restrictions, though. Number one,
the global pandemic. We didn't want to be reckless and spend time around massive groups of people. That means avoiding restaurants, if they're even open, and only participating in outdoor, socially distant activities. You get the point. Restriction number two.
We were traveling on Christmas Eve and Christmas Day, meaning, again, no restaurants are open, lodging is going to be hard to find, and prices will be astronomical everywhere we go. Oh, and I also had to work remotely Christmas Eve, which means we needed to find a place with Wi-Fi that night.
Restriction number three, Winnie. She looked at me when I said that. We love her, but finding a restaurant and hotel that are open and safe during the holidays and a global pandemic are difficult. But these things also need to allow dogs.
So needless to say, our options were slim, and most things would be completely out of our control.
Constant uncertainty and a total loss of control? Yeah. Sounds like the most fitting way to end the year 2020.
Have a good cloudy day.
Not much civilization, I mean, but I think that's kind of a good thing.
Yeah. In a pandemic.
All right, we just got done with our first stop. Winnie took a pee. Oh my gosh. Did you do that to her?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I just saw her face. Oh. I just saw her snout sticking out. Hey, Winnie.
She was cold.
Oh, that's nice.
So am I.
How's it going, Lindsay?
Good. I'm just working. How are you?
Doing good. Lindsay found it easier to sit in the back.
Well, I have to be, because my charger charges the trunk.
This is as far as I can make it.
But it is comfy back here. Plus, I got Winnie with me. I hope we can get some food soon.
So we just stopped for gas. Lindsay's in there. Winnie's back here, just loving this little fan, this heater that's blowing in her face.
You keep locking me out.
I'm not locking, it's the car that does it on its own. We have this running gag. Every time I start the car, it locks on its own. And Lindsay thinks I'm doing it on purpose just to spite her.
She's locking me out in the cold.
It is really cold. Okay, so I looked it up, and so while you're in there, It's good that you got snacks, because apparently that Subway right there is the only restaurant in this town. Surprisingly, this town has two Dairy Queens. It's snowing, as you can see, but we are here. This is our first short stop of the day.
It's so cold here. I didn't expect it to be so cold. It's snowy here, but Winnie she's basking. She's loving it. We've got the heater on. She's on the bed closest to it. She made herself right at home. And I think I'm ready for dinner. Hotel we're gonna stay in yet, so we gotta figure that out, and then that will determine which location in Colorado we go to.
Oh wow.
The mountains all around.
Today's the day. It's just going to be like mountains on mountains on mountains.
I'm excited.
Taking her to go to the bathroom. Come on, let's go this way. This is the little town we stayed in last night. We didn't see any of these mountains because of the... Oh, good, she went. Because of the... obviously, it was dark. But it's pretty.
I believe we're in Colorado now.
Yeah, we are southern Colorado. We went up north to Colorado from New Mexico. Now we're heading west toward the mountains, basically. With Ouray being our final destination of the day. It's just really pretty countryside with basically what looks like a desert, flat grassland. Obviously, it's wintertime, so it's kind of gray and brown, but we're surrounded on all sides by mountains. Within about 5 miles on all sides. Pretty cool. How's it going?
Good.
So we made it through a big mountain pass. Took Winnie to the bathroom. Lindsay got some snacks. We're about 100 miles from Ouray. It's about like an hour and a half probably till we get there.
Woohoo! We are booked!
Where at?
The Ouray Inn, and they were super cool. We have a king kitchenette room. They're gonna put breakfast in our fridge.
Oh.
And ready for us. And they're closing their lobbies today, so they're gonna just leave the key for us at the front door.
Great. Ouray Inn.
Ouray Inn.
Ouray Inn, here we come. Puppy, you excited about that? Hey. No? Good. Cabin resort, and we're gonna see which one is ours.
One ten. Oh, wait, what am I doing?
Here, let me try. Watch your step. Here. Oh. Wow, this is nice.
Here we are.
what's it called? It's on.
The Polar Express.
So we are here at the cabin lodge in Ouray.
I'm sending my mom a picture.
Yeah. It's cool. It's very small and it's very like cozy, quaint. Basically everything that you would want this cabin to be.
Yeah.
Here's Winnie. She's not allowed on any of the furniture. It's a two-bed cabin. Obviously, we're just throwing all of our stuff on one bed. But yeah, here's out the window, basically. It's a little town covered in snow. We're gonna go check it out. Lindsay has to work, but we're gonna go check it out later.
I'm gonna see when those hot springs.
Oh yeah, just go down the road, there's a row of hot springs.
Yeah.
And Lindsay, this is our first or second, I don't know, destination of this trip. What are your thoughts so far?
It's beautiful. Look at this.
It's crazy. I never thought I would spend like a Christmas here. There's a lot of really good restaurants. I hope they're still open, you know, with COVID and everything, but.
Yeah. It seemed like when I was looking that everything was pretty well still open.
That's good. We just got coffees and stuff. Winnie's with us. We're gonna explore some more. Yeah. We decided to walk. I think tonight when we get dinner, we'll take the car.
Sure. During the day when the sun is out.
My hands are just freezing.
Dude, I'm sure you gotta wear gloves.
Wait, come on. Find a place. Well, that was a failure. No. All right, so we just woke up. This is Christmas morning.
Merry Christmas.
Here's our little cabin in the mountains. We're trying to get Winnie to come. Come on, Winnie. Come on. Come on. Come on. You're doing good.
Come on, baby.
We're gonna try and walk. And we got a little bag in case Winnie doesn't want to walk after a while, but we're just gonna try and go into town. Good job, Winnie. She likes the snow, she just has complications with it. Come on, Winnie. Try and get over the. Come on. Come on. Okay, now run down the hill. Come on. Good girl. There you go. Walking into town.
Well, we're gonna try and see if this Maggie's Kitchen is open. I tried to see if they have like an Instagram or a Facebook, or if their Google hours were updated, and they don't, so we'll see. But if that's not open, we might just explore a little bit and figure it out.
So that's downtown. We're just walking in the middle of the street, but the camera doesn't really show the scale of the mountains that we're walking up to. Just the entire town is like surrounded by these mountains.
Yuri is usually home to tons of great local shops and restaurants that line the main street through town. But today nearly everything was closed. So it was kind of an eerie feeling walking through the mostly empty streets of a beautiful town. I definitely hope these shop owners closed by choice. It was Christmas Day after all, but it's also 2020, so you could never really say for sure.
A lot of these cool shops, like we just passed an art gallery that's closed. It looks like there's not much open today. Maybe stuff will open. We're gonna be here today and tomorrow. So stuff will probably kick back open tomorrow.
Sure.
Yeah,
Yeah, so now might be a day to go explore. We can walk down by the hot springs, check those out. So here's a park in case you wanted to play baseball. It had like a loop, and we turned around and you can actually see the mountains start to open up a little bit. And it's crazy how on camera it doesn't really do it justice, but
it's so gorgeous.
It's just the views and the scale of everything is unreal. The only place open for lunch was this Thai place.
Yeah.
And Winnie's back here too. And so we were looking for some cool spots to eat, and we kind of took a wrong turn, but we ended up going up this little mountain pass, and it overlooks all of Ouray, which is cool.
Gorgeous. How are you feeling?
Good. Got a shrimp tempura. The mountains. This is definitely the most unconventional Christmas I've ever had in my life. I don't know about you.
Yeah, for sure.
Woke up in a cabin in the mountains. What do you think, Lindsay?
I mean, the view speaks for itself.
Felt like my tires were like bending. They kind of feel like jello-y. But they're fine.
Maybe it's the snow.
Yeah. The snow up here is pretty.
It's not frozen. Steep.
Yeah, it's like, I don't know if you can see that. It's like pure snow. There's no like pavement to be seen underneath it. Every once in a while you'll get to a patch that's like thick, and you'll just feel like you're going through a snowbank or something. It's not quite as packed down as it is in the town.
I showed everybody before you got on the phone.
Yes, I didn't even know you guys were going anywhere.
But like, that's check that out, all the way around us.
And you probably get a lot of good stuff out there.
What?
You probably get a lot of deer out there.
Yes, yeah, we saw some wild, like, mountain goats.
Oh.
And there's hot.
Yeah, that's like the best place to be, because I bet. I'm just assuming it's probably pretty quiet out there, right?
Oh, yeah, it's super quiet. And because there's all the snow, you know, it's kind of like absorbs all the sound.
What's going on?
Huh? Just packing. We're heading out to go to Grand Canyon, our last stop. Last stop of the trip. It's been a good trip.
so far, but we still got green lettuce.
Pat, what are we doing?
Going to Mesa Verde.
Did we, was this in the plan?
Not really, we're just... What are they doing? They're like handing presents back and forth.
We pulled up here and we were like, should we do it? And then we were like, let's do it. And then we pulled up to like check in and then we were like, meh, maybe we won't. We turned around and then... We were like, ah, let's do it, and we turned around again. And then we were like, ah, maybe we won't, we turned around again.
But good,
then,
how are you?
Of course, we turned around one more time.
Yeah.
And now we're here. We're not accepting cash at this
time, it is card only. Oh, okay. It is going to be $20. Here you go. Okay, so I don't know what exactly we're driving into, so we'll see.
Fire danger, moderate.
You sounded disappointed.
I never want...
The dwelling's 23 miles.
I never want there to be fires.
Alright, welcome to Mesa Verde. The top loop, which is also on the path we chose, is a self-guiding auto tour of 600 years of ancestral Puebloan architectural development. Short paved walkways, most are wheelchair.
So that's where I think where we just were, mountain region wise.
All right, I'm gonna read you a little bit of the history here. The Pueblo.
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 Yeah. Got it that time.
Ancestral.
Mesa tops, ancestral Pueblo people grew crops and hunted game on the Mesa tops.
And Lindsay's still trying to figure out how to say Pueblo.
I got it. Pueblo.
My ears are popping.
Mine too.
So what are we doing right now, Lindsay?
Well, this is called the Geological Overlook at Mesa Verde in Arizona. Right? Or Colorado? Where's Mesa Verde?
This is Colorado.
Okay. In Mesa Verde, Colorado.
Well, it's not the city.
It's called Mesa Verde and it's in Colorado.
Yeah.
But the views are just beautiful. Really, really cool. It's like, also like, there's snow on the ground, but I'm not cold at all. Like, the sun is so warm.
Go any further.
Stop! Oh my god, I'm gonna pee my pants. Adam, get over here. I don't like it. Village, so that was like a little community spot. That was their first one, then they moved to this one and they started a new building structure. So down there in the lower portion you would have like just kind of like a community area, and then up here they would store stuff. And you can see like it's a later version because they have the event again like in the other one. They got that fire pit in the center where they would have gathered, and stone instead of wood. So this is going to be one of the latest, right before they migrated. This is Sun Temple, this is the thing I've been wanting to see this whole time. It's like one of their final builds. Sun Temple is a never-ending source of speculation for scholars and visitors alike. The largest, most striking D-shaped structures in the ancestral Pueblo world, such as
Pueblo.
There's no A there.
Pueblo. Dang it.
So do you think they built these little fences too?
Yeah, definitely.
So what did you think of Mesa Verde?
Loved it. Love stuff like that. Love weird old temples. I know it sounds weird, but like human sacrifice-y, and like then also it's just like insane, the like technology and stuff. Super freaking smart people.
Mesa Verde was incredible, and it's spontaneous stops like this that make these kinds of road trips special. We continued west toward the Four Corners region, where Colorado, New Mexico, Arizona, and Utah all merge into one point on the map.
Step in front of a runaway train.
It's not every day you get the opportunity to stand in four states at once. The only problem was the sun was going down, and being in the middle of the desert at night didn't sound like the most appealing thing, so we had to hurry.
Aching chest and blur aside. It's so far away. It's so far away. Cold wind blows into the skin. Can't believe the state you're in. It's so far, so far away. It's so far, so far. Who are you trying to impress? Steadily creating a mess.
So, we made it to Four Corners Monument. Unfortunately, it's closed. That's the monument, just over there. But, yeah, we're here. It's really beautiful out. We just, we were driving west, facing the sunset, watching the sun go down all day, so that was pretty cool. But, what do you think, Lindsay?
It's pretty.
Can't quite stand on the monument, but...
four places at once, almost.
Yeah. It's really pretty.
Let's just stand under that.
Maybe someday we'll come back with enough time when they're not closed, you know. But man, the sunset's really pretty. Anyway, back in the car. Next stop is Flagstaff. Where we were yeah, the whole trip, this was a Grand Canyon trip, which is weird because I feel like we've done a lot more than just this. We're on this road. We just left Flagstaff, Arizona, and we are just got coffee, got gas, all that stuff, and now we're headed to the Grand Canyon.
Oh, you're wondering about how Winnie's doing? Boop. She's just sleepy, sleepy, sleepies. All she does is sleep, sleep, sleep. She got crazy last night because she slept in the car.
Yeah, she slept for the whole day yesterday, so when we got back to the hotel, she was really crazy wanting to play.
Can you see it? It's snowing. It's snowing. It was supposed to be raining. What?
Right as this is the line to get into the park, I think, where you have to pay. Looks like there's a lot of people had the same idea we did.
Winnie, what do you think? We're going to see the Grand Canyon. She's just looking at me like, where are we stopped?
Where are we?
Grand Canyon. Well, the parking lot.
The visitor center here.
I'm not sure where to even go. Where is the visitor center?
I think it's that building up there. I was expecting like 50s. So I like only have my light overcoat on. So we're going to have to get some bundling up going here.
Are dogs allowed in the visitor center?
Let's see.
I don't think it says.
What are we doing, Lindsay?
We're walking to the Grand Canyon.
So here's the Grand Canyon. I mean, it's just incredibly, it's way more epic than you would ever imagine. Like, yeah, those people are freaking out, but I think for good reason. Let's keep walking. What do you think?
It's crazy. I totally want to get down in there.
Yeah.
So I want to like hike.
Yeah, they're going to be
kayaking. So we're just hiking down this little trailhead to the abyss. Mm-hmm. All right, we just came down that little crack right there, and we're on this like, it's like a 45 degree down into the canyon. So we just kind of came down that little slope. I got Winnie in my hands. Lindsay's down here. Made it to this outcropping down. There's the canyon down there. And we're at like eye level with the clouds, which is kind of cool. But we're gonna take some pics.
You ready? Yeah. 1, 2, 3. Take another one. 2, 3. It's awesome.
Winnie's doing good. We just, we crawled back up. It's pretty cool. She's really good at these little trails. She's narrow and has a low center of gravity. Lindsay's taking a picture of the little spot where we were just standing. So we were, yeah, we were just standing right here.
I cannot believe that's where we were.
At that point, right?
We should get a selfie right here.
Thank you. And we made it home. We made it.
Ready for trip one up the stairs.
Now we are. We are back home. We are going to load up all of our crap. Winnie's happy to be home. Come on, Winnie.
Let's go. Got the keys?